I think it's very critical that science and faith inform one another, because they are efforts to understand life, efforts to understand the human person, efforts to understand the world in which we live. And the more that science and theology can intertwine, can appreciate the insights of one another, I think we become much more knowledgeable about these very important issues. Well, I think there are many important scientific issues that face the church, but I would say certainly trying to understand how our moral teaching is enveloped or understood more fully through scientific research. You know, we speak often about ethics, we speak often about moral teaching, but science has an opportunity to help us to delve deeply into human life, into the world in which we live, and to help understand a little more clearly what are the purposes of life, what is the meaning of life, who am I, where am I come from, where am I going, what is the best way to live my life. And so I think there's a broad range of scientific questions that affect us in our efforts to understand the human person. Well, I think Pope Francis has helped us in his beautiful document, Laudato Si, to understand that as people of faith, we also have to understand the effects and understandings and learnings of science. And so I think for seminarians, it's absolutely critical that they have a deeper sense of the teaching of science, of the insights of science, of the learnings that we can understand through science, so that it can help our efforts to try to bring the faith into the meaning of people's lives, into the directions of people's lives. So I think it's extremely important for seminarians to at least have some immersion into science, so that they can speak intelligently, can speak reflectively about some of the issues and questions that people have. Of course, our world is developing so quickly, so rapidly, a technology is developing so rapidly, that it's important that seminarians not shun those learnings, not avoid those learnings, but try to inculcate them into their teaching and their preaching. Well, I think it would be a terrible mistake to think that seminarians should not be exposed more directly to some scientific learning, because science today is advancing so rapidly and helping us to understand so many human questions, societal questions. And so for people to say that seminarians should have no connection to science, should have no immersion in scientific study, I think would be a terrible mistake, because today science and technology are such developing fields of study, and to be exposed to those, to be introduced to those. Now, obviously, seminarians are not going to be scientists, maybe a few will be, but they ought to have some knowledge, some understanding, some appreciation, and certainly respect for the importance of science in understanding the world in which we live.